My next guest es de España. And she's the only tennis player to beat both Serena and Venus Williams in a Grand Slam final. Please welcome the 2017 Wimbledon women's single champion, Garbiñe Muguruza. The picture of you right after you won on the screen, please. Aww. You can never get sick and tired of seeing people win, you know?
No.
And I bet you probably feel the same way about yourself.
It is. When you want to win, you want to win more, and more is addictive.
So what did you say to Venus after you beat her?
Nothing. I didn't say anything. I don't know. I'm like, well played. I was like, you know, in tears and super emotional, so I don't remember. I think she said something to me, but...
What did Serena say to you when she beat you at Wimbledon?
She said, you're going to win this in the future, but I don't think she meant it, playing her sister. And I'm like, well...
So this is not your first Grand Slam, because you won the French Open, right?
Yes.
And you beat Venus in this round. So you've beaten mm-hmm. Venus and Serena, which nobody ever beats those bitches. Venus. Sometimes people can beat Venus, but Serena, I mean, is very, very difficult to beat, right?
It's very hard. I mean, they're the best tennis players since a very long time. And it's funny because when I won the final, when they gave me the mic, I was like, I've watched Venus since I was a little girl, and the entire stadium started laughing. You know, because it's true. When I was younger, I was watching her play, and then 10 years after, I'm actually playing her. So, yeah, for sure, they're the toughest opponents.
What is it like when you go out and you play a match like that? Are you superstitious? What do you think? Do you think I'm gonna win, and then?
No, never know what's gonna happen, you know? I'm trying to be confident, but I was, like, very nervous, I can tell you, you know, shaking and stuff, because it's a Grand Slam final, you know, it's the match. You know, you work so hard to be there, and I felt like 2 years ago, I played the Wimbledon final and I lost to Serena. And I'm like, I have another chance and I know what it is to lose in the final. It's nothing comparable. Nobody remembers the one who loses in the final.
Yeah.
It's all about winning. So I'm like, this one is mine. So I was like, you know, trying so hard to win.
Very remarkable. And exciting. And when you go out on the court and you're nervous, you said you were nervous. Like, what happens? And then you start playing and you're okay, or you're just nervous the entire match? When does it, like, abate a little bit?
Well, the worst is to wait, the waiting or the day before, because once you go in the court and you start sweating, I'm like, okay, this is tennis. This is what I know what to do, you know? But it's just the moments before you're thinking, you're like, oh my God, I gotta play tomorrow. All these people watching me, I'm playing a final, I'm playing Williams. But then when I went out there, I'm like, I'm good here.
Did you feel like the crowd was on your side? Because it sounded like the crowd was on your side when you were winning.
Yeah, when I started winning.
In the second set, yes.
Yes.
They're fickle that way.
At the beginning, I felt a little bit more with Venus, but the best is when the crowd is like equal. You know, they cheer for one, they cheer for the other one, because if it's like just for one, it's like not balanced.
Yeah,
you know,
no, so when that they doesn't feel good at all.
Yes, when they cheer for both, it makes us such a competitive arena, and uh-huh. then we get so excited.
And how did you celebrate? What do you do when you win Wimbledon? How do you go out and what happens?
Nothing.
I was afraid, because athletes don't ever get to celebrate, especially girls. You guys don't. You got to go out and make it happen.
I know. I have to.
Wimbledon. You got to go out and celebrate.
I know. I went to a Spanish restaurant, had some fun, but you know what? I was exhausted. You know, I did so many interviews, the match, the tension, the nerves. I'm like, don't bother me. I just want to just leave me alone, you know? And then with the time, I did, you know, I went out a little bit, but I will. I think I need time.
You need time to settle in.
Every day I will a little bit.
Yeah, and it's nice to wake up. I think the best thing about a huge victory like that, I would imagine, would be to wake up the next morning. Not the moment it happens, but to wake up yes. in your bed and be like, I just won Wimbledon.
Yeah.
Right?
And I have the trophy here.
Yeah.
Next to me, yeah.
So you're from Spain, where are you from in Spain?
From Barcelona.
Oh, okay, yeah. Yes. I'm learning Spanish. Spanish for about 3 years.
And how is it?
I estado practicando más con mi maestra. No, con mi amigas, con mi cleaning lady. How do you say?
Anyway. I don't know.
Yeah, I'm working on it, but I'm not giving up because I have a house in Spain. I bought a house in Spain a few years ago, and one day I'm going to move there.
Really?
And I want to learn the language. Yeah, so I take my Spanish classes every week. It's just a matter of practicing.
Where is the house?
Yes. That I take the Spanish classes at?
Where are you?
Well, I'll tell you later.
Oh.
Anyway. So, okay. Is this a present for me, or am I supposed to give this to you? I never know what's supposed to go on here.
No, this is for you, because I know you love tennis.
Yeah, I do love tennis. I'm not very good, though.
Well, that's okay.
Oh, Stella McCartney tennis gear. Oh, yeah, this is so me.
This is my outfit.
This is so something I wear.
This is what I wore. Well, not exactly one,
but... Oh, it is?
Yes.
Well, send me the one you actually wore.
I'm keeping that one.
No, that would probably fit me.
My mind goes crazy. No. So you can play.
Stella sends me stuff all the time, Stella McCartney.
Really?
Is she a friend of yours, Stella McCartney? She sends me lingerie.
I never met her. I want to meet her.
Don't need to meet her. She's fine.
Okay.
But she sends me lingerie all the time, and it's like, Stella, you know me. Like, we're friends. She knows that I would never in my life ever wear lingerie, yet she continues to send me little panties and bras. Like,
really?
First of all, who would ever see me in lingerie and be like, They'd be like, what are you doing? Where's the camera? Tell us about your charity, Room to Read.
Yes, well, I started working with them recently, and I felt touched, you know, and I needed to feel something like this to be able to, I don't know, do something. I need to feel identified, and it's about girls' education and literacy, and it's also in Africa and Asia. And I like the story, and especially that it's for girls, which I think is necessary for them. They can, I don't know, educate their children.
Yeah.
And, I feel like I could do something, especially in South America, maybe. They're starting a new project in Peru. So, I don't know, I feel like I have to help.
Yeah, you have to give back. When you're really successful and you're on the world stage, you have to give back. And helping girls read and get educated throughout the world, which is a big problem, is worthwhile. If you'd like to help Garbiñe's charity, you can go to roomtoread.org. And next week, she'll be competing in the Bank of the West Classic, which is in Stanford. Thank you very much. Since you got to the end of that video, I'm going to show you something that's going to blow your mind. I realize that I've never walked up this staircase on my set, and I don't know what's behind this door at the top, so we're just going to find out together. And...
Hey guys, hit the subscribe button right now for more videos.